Welcome to this tutorial on how to register your company in the EPO's Procurement Portal. You will learn how to register as a new supplier. The registration of your company can be initiated directly by you or can be the follow-up of an email request sent to you by an EPO buyer. Either way, the registration must be approved by the EPO before your company is considered as an active supplier. You can find the link to the procurement portal on the EPO website. On the portal landing page, you need to click on New Supplier, Register Now, on the right side of the screen to enter your company information. To complete the company's information, you need to fill in the mandatory fields, indicated by the red asterisk. If you are not sure of the meaning of the field, hover over the information icon. The first field to complete is the supplier, which is the official name of the company. Also, you can choose your language preferences. Scrolling down the page, you can search for the address. The system will make proposals or suggestions. You need to check that the information provided is correct. To uniquely identify the supplier, you will be asked to enter at least one identifying number, for example, the tax number, the VAT number, the DUNS number, or your commercial register. The system will require at least one, but ideally, you can enter more. The more complete the information, the easier will be the subsequent collaboration between your company and the EPO. You can check the expected format by clicking on the information icon of each field. It is necessary to enter the contact details. First name, last name, and email are mandatory. Below, you need to create a password. To do so, you need to follow the instructions described on the screen. For example, passwords have to be at least 10 characters. The next step is the data protection statement. After confirming that, by clicking on the tick box, enter the security control code. Once the security control is completed, you can scroll up the page and click on the register button. Immediately after, you will receive a confirmation that you have been registered. Then, click on Go Back to Login Page button and you will be directed to the login page. On the right side of the screen, you can immediately log in the identification section with your email address and password you have just created. When you click on Login for the first time, you will need to accept the terms and conditions. First, select the field I accept the terms and conditions, and then click on the Acknowledge button. For the data protection statement, you will need to follow the same steps described before. Once the terms and conditions and the data protection statement are accepted, you will be automatically directed to the procurement portal. For further information, check out the frequently asked questions and answers about the procurement portal on the EPO website, and, if needed, you can write to our supplier help desk at the email address supplier@epo.org.